The future is bright indeed. We're all of us dreaming of the better days ahead, and a part of your bright new future could be a move to where the magic lives in the greater Orlando area of Florida. One of the biggest decisions you'll make when considering a move is selecting a realtor who can successfully match you with the right home in the right location at the right price. Victor Naraki is the realtor who can help you make the move you've always wanted to. Whether you're a first-time homeowner or looking to move near Disney World, Victor is in your corner. If you are looking for an experienced real estate agent covering all of Central Florida, please visit DisneyAtYourDoorstep.com today and find out just why you should work with Victor. I encourage you to create a free, no-obligation account on his website. By doing so, you'll unlock the website's full potential and be able to enter specific criteria, save listings, and browse new properties sent to your email. Visit DisneyAtYourDoorstep.com today or visit his Facebook page, Victor Naraki Realtor. And don't forget to tell him the Grand Circle Tour podcast sent you.
The Disneyland Limited, now leaving for a Grand Circle Tour of the Magic Kingdom. All passengers board.
Star Tours announces the boarding of the Endor Express. All passengers, please prepare for immediate boarding.
Please stand clear of the doors. Por favor, manténganse alejado de las puertas.
To those guests who've just joined us, welcome. For those of you standing, please hold on to the handrails throughout our journey and stay clear of the doors.
Please keep your hands, arms, and legs inside the train and remain seated at all times. Now, hang on to them hats and glasses, because this here's the wildest ride in the wilderness.
I am Sam the American Eagle, and I am proud to introduce the Grand Circle Tour Podcast, a celebration of Disney parks, but mostly the American ones. I really like these guys.
Hello, passengers, and welcome to Adventure 221 of the Grand Circle Tour Podcast. I am your host, Mission Commander Justin, and joining me on deck tonight are my two favorite co-hosts. On my left in the navigation officer's chair is Conductor Dan. How are you doing today, Dan? And what's up with you?
Justin, how are you today? It is 32 days away? 32 days away? Is that our countdown?
Who's counting, really?
32 days. Let me check. Hold on. Everyone's got that app on their phone, right? Let me pull that up real quick. It's 32 days away. Our trip. I cannot wait to hang out with the both of you and more. For those that don't know, we will be having a meetup at Margaritaville Resort. That's the resort, not the restaurant. On August the 19th at, what time is it? 2 o'clock? Is that what we said?
2 o'clock, local Florida time.
Florida time. Go to the lobby, reach out to one of us, and we will tell you where we are. But can't wait, guys. I worked on a Dan game for all the fun that we're going to have, and everyone's going to play a Dan game.
What the Dan games are like, so we're all looking forward
Justin
to that.
Justin loves the Dan game. And I bought prizes.
Ooh.
Yeah, you guys
are fancy.
You guys will be part of the game, too. So you, Justin, you yourself may win a prize. Who knows?
That will be fun. And I know we'll tell you again before we get there, but as you go through the lobby going to the left side in the back, you'll see like a general store kind of thing. And just through there, we've got a seating area, and that's where we'll all be. So we'll tell you between now and then, but I shouldn't have even said anything. Now you know who else is here.
It's not exactly a surprise, but to my other left in the communications officer chair, of course, is our wonderful cruise director, Beatrice. So how are you doing tonight, Beatrice?
Fantastic. Sorry for jumping right in, but you know,
that's
I know where
right.
We're going to be at Margaritaville. I've scoped it out, and so I just had to throw my 2 cents worth in, and I can't wait to see everybody out there. That's going to be great. I am fantastic. We are just starting the Food and Wine Festival at Epcot, and we're going to be talking about that on our live shows in the next few weeks, so I won't spoil too much of that. But it's been very fun to taste a couple of things, see a band, just do all kinds of lots of fun stuff. So it's been a great couple of days so far.
Yeah, and our live shows, I think both crews are talking about the Food and Wine Festival this time. So we got the East Coast crew talking about like some of the merchandising and the bands and all of that, and then the Midwest crew we're going to talk about some of the food like we usually do. So that's going to be a lot of fun coming up.
It will be.
Do you guys know that this is my first food and wine festival ever?
Really?
This is the first time you've been there for food and wine?
Yeah, and well, that's because it's super early, right?
Yes. Oh my gosh. From now, July to November. Can you believe it?
It's crazy. I couldn't believe it.
Usually like October and November, and that was it. And now it's like starting in July.
I'll be there in August for Food and Wine Festival, which is usually the fall and Halloween. So, you know, the Halloween party. So I'm all like falled out, you know. That's what I feel like.
So when you are here, you're going to be here, what, August 19th and 20th to see Journey's former lead singer? And then the 21st and 22nd is Air Supply. So you got some good ones coming up.
Oh,
nice.
I think I'll be at Epcot. What day is it? I think I'm
there the 21st.
What day is that? Supply.
Is that Sunday or is that a Sunday?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. I'm there the 22nd. What's the 22nd features?
22nd is also Air Supply. 21 right. and 22. So that'll be good.
Well,
speaking of Air Supply.
Yeah, I was going to say. So since we're talking about music, that is our topic for tonight, is we are going to talk about Disney music. Various bits of our Disney music. Now, before we started, Dan reminded me that we have talked about Disney music on this show a few times in the past, and he's run a few music-themed games. But when I was looking through, I didn't see... I must have missed a couple of them or something, because I was like, how have we not talked about this more? Our favorite pieces of Disney music, because there is so much Disney music to choose from, whether you're talking attractions, movies, fireworks shows, you name it. There's so much to choose from. And I thought this would be a lot of fun for a topic for tonight. So that is our topic for tonight. We're going to kind of go around the table and just talk about some of our favorite bits of Disney music. And how about we start with Dan? What is one of your favorite pieces of Disney music that you'd like to talk about?
So Justin, before I start with my list, I just want to tell everyone how I like my thought process here, because I'm a huge music fan, right? Music is my life. I play in some instruments. I play the drums. I dabble with other things. And you guys know the radio, or the Disney radio on Sirius? I don't know if you guys have Sirius radio, but they have the Disney station. I listen to it all the time. And they have this thing called Be Our Guest for a Day. And there's always a commercial that says, hey, if you want a guest DJ, pick 4 songs, and Disney picks the people, like if they want to do it. So I went ahead and thought of like the perfect 4 songs, in my opinion, for a casual Disney radio listener. And I did this about a month ago. So I know we're probably going to do a little bit more than 4, but I'm going to start with those 4 songs. And I'm going to tell you the reasons why I picked them.
So okay.
That was my thought process. And there's a couple different reasons. So the first one I went with, and I may get some like, I'm not sure if people will argue this or not, because technically it was not a Disney song when it was written and performed originally. But it's Disney now, because Disney owns the IP. And what's our favorite IP, Justin, of all time?
Well, we've got all of them. Star Wars, Muppets. I mean,
it's the Muppets. That's our favorite. Come on. Right? The Muppets is our favorite. So if you know where I'm going here, I have to put Rainbow Connection at the top of my list as my all-time favorite. Okay, maybe it wasn't written when it was part of Disney, but it's on Radio Disney now on Sirius, and that's all that matters.
Why are there so many songs about rainbows, and what's on the other side? Rainbows are visions, but only illusions, and rainbows have nothing to hide. dreamers and me.
This song is a part of my childhood. It's a part of my adulthood. It's a part of my life. It's been through me, with me growing up, through hard times, through good times, and the way that Kermit sings it, the feelings that you get, the empowerment that I get when I feel it. Those are all the reasons why I love this song. There's been a bunch of covers. There's some times where I'll put in Rainbow Connection on my have YouTube Music, and I just put it on there, and they'll just play cover after cover after cover. And it's great to see different artists' rendition of it, interpretations of it. And it's just, you know, it's one of my favorites. I think it was nominated for Academy Award I think it was 79. Is that when the Muppet movie
came out? I want to say like 78 or 79 is when Muppet movie came out. Yeah.
I think I was two. So I was born in 77. So I think it was 79. And it was written for the Muppet movie, but it became so much more than just a song for a movie.
You know, back when I was in choir in high school, that's one of the songs I sang for competition.
Yep.
Yeah. And I absolutely love the Muppet movie and all of the music in it. Moving Right Along is one of my favorite songs from that film, as well as I'm Going to Go Back There Someday, as sung by Gonzo. And I actually even enjoy the Muppets from Space version a little better.
I'm playing all the old Muppet movies for my kids right now. So we're up to The Great Muppet Caper right now. So
I go through all the movies. I mean, even go through 2011 when you go, Are You a Man or a Muppet? Like, yep. All of the music is just fantastic. It doesn't matter. You just keep on going through the years of Muppets.
I'm in. I have several albums of just Muppet music, and I love every song on every one of them.
The best part of the song is the third verse that I think is the least known verse, and I was listening to a rendition of Jason Mraz. I don't know if anyone knows who Jason Mraz is. Great singer. And he sings it, and the way he sings it, it's so eerie. And I'll just say the lyrics right now if I can remember offhand, but it's have you been half asleep, and have you heard the voices? I've heard them calling my name. Just like it's, and then you know, he goes on to say,
is this the sweet song
that calls the young sailor? The voice might be one and the same. I've heard it too many times to ignore it. It's something that I'm supposed to be. I don't know. To me, it's like those words, those lyrics, like mean something. You know, it's very powerful.
That is an absolutely wonderful pick, Dan. I love it.
It is.
Beatrice, you're up next. What is one of your favorite pieces of Disney music that you'd like to share with us?
When you talk about, we all have our own personal stories and, you know, life lessons along the way. So my absolute number one favorite with everything I've done in all my life is Hercules Go the Distance.
No, you did not just steal this one,
yes.
Did you?
Oh, I'm telling you, this is mine.
I have often dreamed of a far off great warm welcome will be waiting for me, where the crowds will cheer when they see my face, and a voice keeps saying, this is where I'm meant to be. I will find my way, I can go the distance, I'll be there someday. If I can be strong, I know every mile will be worth my while. I would go most anywhere to feel like I belong.
it's wonderful when it's in, you know, the castle shows and all of that stuff, when it's in the fireworks and everything. But let me tell you, back in the day, in the early 2000s, 2003, I actually performed, I did a bodybuilding show. So every morning when I got up at stupid o'clock in the morning to go, you know, do my run in the morning, lift weights in the evening, Hercules, Go the Distance was one of a couple of my top songs that I played on that CD as we go. It was a song that was written for the movie. It's on the Alan Menken songbook. It's so motivating. So it made me feel like, it kind of helped me inspire myself to get to Florida too. You know, I want to go where I feel like I belong. I didn't really feel like I belonged where I was, you know, and now I feel like I'm exactly where I'm supposed to be. And it's just everything about that song just hits home. And I just absolutely love it. I cry when I see it on the fireworks shows. But it is definitely my A number one, and it helped me through a lot of stuff over the decades. So there you go. I'm taking it.
Well, it is probably my all time favorite song from a movie. And it's not a coincidence that it's used on most, you know, fireworks shows because of just the words and the meanings behind it. And really the rhythm in the, you know, the beginning part where it's just the music playing. It probably would have won an Academy Award for best song if it wasn't for that little movie, Titanic. I don't know if you guys have ever heard of it.
Yeah.
My Heart Will Go On. I don't know if you guys ever heard that song, but if it wasn't for that.
Yes. Yeah, that was a good year for music, but I'm telling you, I'm on my way. I can go the distance. I don't care how far. Somehow I'll be strong. I mean, just every little bit of that just sinks it down to home. And it's the perfect Walt Disney song for whatever the case may be.
And there's something about the way that the actor that plays the young Hercules.
Roger Bart.
There you go. If you remember,
I'm not saying that this might have been somewhere on my list as well.
If you remember, the artist who sang it in the end credits was Michael Bolton. Yeah. And that was the song that, you know, they tried to push, but somehow the Roger Bart's version is the one that's memorable and the one that everyone thinks of. The one that was actually sung in the song, not the end credit version.
Yeah, they do that sometimes where they'll have a different artist like that sing the song. And it's like, honestly, I don't care. It's the song that I heard during the film that resonates with me more. In this case and in several others.
Same here, yep. We had that same situation with another song that I walked down the aisle to on our wedding day. And they're like, do you want this version? We're like, no, we want the movie version.
Of course we want the movie version. Why wouldn't we?
Right, exactly. I'm like, sorry. I know you can sing it just as well. But no, I don't want that. I want Angela Lansbury to sing it. Yep.
So I can go in a lot of different directions for my next pick, but one of them, the first one I thought of is, and this is why I'm going to bring it up first, is because it was the first one that came to my mind when I thought of this topic. And that is, it's one that, again, you know, wasn't originally necessarily written for Disney, but Disney uses it. And that's Owl City's When Can I See You Again, which was used, of course, in Wreck-It Ralph and the Paint the Night Parade.
You moved my stump! I'm gonna wreck it!
I can fix it!
Switch on the sky and the stars glow for you. Go see the world, cause it's all so brand new. Don't close your eyes, cause your future's ready to shine. It's just a matter of time before we learn how to fly. Welcome to the rhythm of the night. There's something in the air you can't deny.
And I love it just because, well, first of all, it's just a fun song to listen to. I enjoy it a heck of a lot. And I enjoy the parade that was in. I enjoy the movie that it was in. And so I love pulling that one up and listening to it. It's on my running mix, and I just absolutely enjoy it.
That's a great one.
I love that.
Sorry, I don't have an emotional story to go along with that one. But
I sing that one all the time. It's one of the ones that I kind of go to when I'm in a little happy place, you know, or like if I've been with friends or something like that. It's like, oh, it's such a great
I also love song. The music video. If you go out on like YouTube, I think they have it there still, where they kind of simulate some of the old 8-bit graphics of the video games because it had been used in Wreck-It Ralph.
Yeah.
Love it.
Good one. All right.
Yeah, you're up next.
All right. Well, I'm going back to the way I thought about these songs for the Sirius station, and Go the Distance was going to be my third one, although it may be my number one song. It was going to be third, and both Go the Distance and Rainbow Connection are a little slower, right? So what I was thinking, I said, I need an upbeat song. I need something that's going to get people moving. And there's one song on the most underrated Disney movie of all time, in my opinion, that gets me moving anytime I hear it. As a matter of fact, today when I was doing some research, I played it, and my three-year-old, who's potty training, by the way, so he may or may have not had clothes on at the time, just started shaking his little butt and dancing around the living room and asked me to play it at least 5 times on my phone. So that's how much the song gets you going. And what's the most underrated movie? Guys, any guesses where I'm going here?
Most underrated. Goofy movie.
Yeah, you got it. That's it. It's Goofy movie, and it's Eye to Eye, who done by Tevin Coleman and Tevin Campbell. I'm sorry, Tevin Campbell. And not always is an upbeat song, it gets you moving, but if you listen to the lyrics, I mean, we all know the story of a Goofy movie. It's about Max and his dad, Goofy, who don't have the greatest relationship. And at the end, they're seeing eye to eye, right? And the last song is if we listen, and it kind of goes with what's going on in the world, not to get too political or anything on this in this show, but if we listen to each other's hearts, we'll find out we're really not that far apart. And maybe love is the reason why, for the first time ever, we're seeing it eye to eye. That's a great lyric to me. And it's a great song, upbeat.
Single one of the Powerline songs in that film are just absolutely wonderful. So I have to agree with you 100% on this one.
As I'm sitting here, I said to myself, we have to do a show of the greatest Disney bands ever made. You know, that should be the next one, right? And I see where Powerline ranks that. I mean, it's going to be pretty hard to beat, in my opinion. But yeah, that's my favorite.
That is absolutely fantastic. I love that whole movie. But yeah, the music in that is just amazing. I think it was one of the guys who like worked on music for Prince, even worked on the music for this, to just try to get that perfect sort of 90s music vibe going. So these are songs that probably could have been released on the radio and taken off just because they're that, just that good.
Yeah.
That's a what wonderful pick, Dan. Beatrice, you're up next.
So my next one is another personal one, and it's from a movie that I think has a fantastic soundtrack, and it's a pretty underrated movie in comparison to how I feel about it, I guess. Brother Bear. Brother Bear has a lot of great songs. One of my favorites was Tell Everybody I'm On My Way. That was another one that I got going with, you know, when I was in my bodybuilding days and I was going to the gym and all that stuff, you know. So, but the one that I really wanted to focus on in this was Look Through My Eyes, because that song has such a wonderful, deep, special, you know, words and meaning. No matter what you're going through in life, some of the words of the song, there are things in life you're learning over time, you'll see, because out there somewhere, it's all waiting if you keep believing. So don't run, don't hide, it'll be all right. You'll see, trust me, I'll be there watching over you. Just take a look through my eyes. You'll be amazed at what you find when you look through my eyes. Just so inspiring to just keep your head up, keep moving forward no matter what you're going through. There are times in life, in our journey, that we're in, you know, maybe harder times or dark moments or something, but boy, Disney music will get you right out of it. I mean, whether it's just keep your head up and keep moving forward, this was one that got me through some great, you know, moments of learning and growing in my life. So Brother Bear, all of it's a wonderful soundtrack, but Look Through My Eyes, Phil Collins did a lot of great stuff on that album, and it was really beautiful. So I'm up for Phil Collins with Brother Bear and Look Through My Eyes.
Yeah, Phil Collins may or may not show up on my list later as well.
He did a lot of great Disney stuff, I'm telling you. Really? Yeah.
So the next one, I'm going to pull out another one that it's also was not originally created for Disney. This one was originally created in 1966 and didn't become a Disney classic until 1972. And it's a song by Perry and Kingsley. It's called Baroque Hoedown, and you might recognize it as the song from Main Street Electrical Parade.
I did not know that was the name of it.
That is the main theme of Main Street Electrical Parade. It's called Baroque Hoedown. Huh. It's a classic piece of electrical synth music. Mm-hmm. And I absolutely, I mean, I love the parade. It's the first parade that, and I've mentioned this on the show many times before, it's the first parade I ever saw in the parks, and I immediately fell in love with it. And so the music is something that, again, I can just put it on whenever, you know, if I'm feeling down, that's the kind of music I can put on and just feel better and just enjoy it. I love it so much.
Very good.
Awesome. Great.
So, Dan, you're up next.
I am up. All right. So, getting back to my five songs I was going to pick, number three would have been Go the Distance.
Sorry. Then... sorry, not sorry.
I wanted something from the parks. And I thought about it, and I thought about our shows that we've done, and like Justin said, earlier, we've done a couple shows from our favorite music from the parks. And although we didn't have rules on those episodes of what type of music, I purposely only did songs from attractions, rides, I should say. So I wanted to go maybe something else, like a show. So when you talk about songs that motivate you, make you feel good, the first song that I think of that motivates me all the time, my favorite show of all time, no longer there in Magic Kingdom, is Happily Ever After. And of course, the song is also called Happily Ever After.
Spark a dream that we're meant to follow, setting out for a new tomorrow.
That song, I'm not that much of a crier. I'm not that much of a mushy, touchy-feely type of guy when I walk on Main Street. Yeah, I get the Disney feels a little bit. But I have never watched Happily Ever After without shedding a tear. I can admit that as a man. every single time it gets me. And I just think it has to do, you know, we all know what the message is, reach out and find your happily ever after, which is ultimately what it's all about and why we all love Disney. But I think that the two artists that sing the song really make the song. Jordan Fisher and Angie Kay. And I think Angie Kay was probably like the more powerful vocal. But Jordan Fisher is like the more popular person. I don't know if you guys know who Jordan Fisher is, but Jordan Fisher's been around.
I know mostly from that song.
well, you know, he actually won Dancing with the Stars. I don't know if you watched that. He won it a couple of years ago because he was in a few things. He actually played John Lawrence in Hamilton for a couple of years after, who's the original actor?
Lin-Manuel.
Yeah, the guy who played John Lawrence, though. Whatever his name is. He took over for him and did a great job. He was on, like, iCarly and, like, Liv and Maddie, all those, like, you know, Teen Disney, like, TV mm-hmm. shows. He was on that, too. So, anyway, I'm a big fan of Jordan Fisher. And this song actually originated in Hong Kong Disneyland for the 10th anniversary celebration. And is currently played on something, I don't know, Justin, if you know this, but it's Mickey and the Wondrous Book stage show. Obviously not sung in English, but and by different singers. It actually still is there today. One of my favorites.
Yeah, that's a great pick. I love so much of the fireworks music, and especially because it is so almost always so uplifting like that. And I also loved Remember Dreams Come True that had come before that, just because it was a nice kind of a nice way to end the day at the park with all of the little bits of sound from the different attractions that I love. But anyway, I digress. Yeah,
that song is on my playlist on my car probably every other day on my way to work.
That's great. Gets you in a good spirit to get to work.
Yep.
Absolutely. Cruise director Beatrice, you're up next. What is another one of your favorite bits of music?
For many years, now I moved to Florida in 2010, and it actually took me a few years, and I still sometimes have a moment where I hear this song and just kind of shed a little tear at how special it is just to be here in this spot. And it starts with, I'm walking right down the middle of Main Street, USA.
How you doing?
I'm walking right down the middle of Main Street, USA. It's the heart of America, the heartbeat of a holiday. The place was named with a magical plan, and just around the corner is a fantasy land. I'm walking right down the middle Street, USA. I hear the music playing from the old-time ragtime band. I feel the whole place swaying with the people from across the land. You see the greatest smiling faces up and down the street. It's remarkable how friendly all the people can be. I'm walking right.
With that welcome ceremony in the morning, there's so many years I do miss that so much. But when I can see that trolley show, it's just the essence of being in this spot. You know, the happy faces, the singers, the trolley, you can see the castle. It's just, it's going to be like, you're going to have a great day. It's just like Tinkerbell is just sending out all her little pixie dust all over you. So that's how I feel with that particular song. I know it appeared in the Main Street section of the stage show, Disneyland is Your Land. It's still heard in Magic Kingdom at the welcome ceremony, if they still had the welcome ceremony, but they still do it along Main Street. So you still get the music and that kind of thing in the trolley show. Whenever we have the talent that are there to sing it and that kind of thing. So that is a very, very special part of any Magic Kingdom day, in my opinion.
Awesome.
Yeah, on the one album that I found it on, it's officially called the Welcome Medley.
Oh, gotcha.
So it may have been on my list as well. And again, it's something I've talked about on the show many times about how much I love that show, and really would like to see it come back, especially the bit, you know, when they were out front on the train station before you went in. Even it was such a wonderful way of like just opening the whole park and letting everyone in. But
yeah, I agree. I wish that they would do it, and you know, even for those who want to just stand and watch it and let other people go in, that's fine, but I would just stand there and enjoy, you know.
So let's see. I'm gonna go in a little different direction here. And this one goes back to, well, basically last week's episode when we were talking about like some older movies that we enjoyed. And it's The Monkey's Uncle from the movie The Monkey's Uncle.
Thank you.
the monkeys, uncle, yeah, yeah. She loves the monkeys, uncle, whoa, whoa. She loves the monkeys, uncle.
And the monkeys, uncle's ate for me. Well, I don't care what the whole world thinks.
She loves the monkeys, uncle.
Call us a couple of missing links.
She loves the monkeys, uncle.
Love all his monkey shines. Every day is Valentine's. I love the monkey's uncle, and the monkey's uncle's ate for me.
Ate for me. Uh-huh. She loves the monkey's uncle, yeah, yeah. She loves the monkey's uncle, whoa, whoa. She loves the monkey's uncle.
And the monkey's uncle's ate for me. We kiss and my heart jumps like a clown.
She loves the monkey's uncle.
Feels like the circus just came to town.
She loves the monkey's uncle.
I'd live in a jungle gym in order to be with him. I love the monkey's uncle, and I wish I were the monkey's aunt.
Monkey's aunt.
The day he marries me,
what a nutty family tree.
A bride,
a groom, a chimpanzee.
Let them say he's the booby prize.
She loves the monkey's uncle.
He's the guy I idolize.
She loves the monkey's uncle.
Love all his monkey shines. Every day is Valentine's. I love the monkey's uncle, and the monkey's uncle's ate for me.
Ate for me. Uh-huh.
I love the monkey's uncle, yeah, yeah. I love the monkey's uncle, whoa, whoa. I love the monkey's uncle, and I'm mad about his chimpanzee.
Partly, I mean, it's just a fun song, but it's also, it's sung by Annette Funicello and the Beach Boys. And apparently Disney got the Beach Boys just before they got really famous. But it's a fun song. I mean, if you love that kind of Beach Boys sort of surfer sound, it kind of fits in with that style of music, and it's a lot of fun. Dan probably wouldn't like the movie because it has a monkey in it.
Yeah, we stay away from it. I haven't seen it because of that.
Well, you can't see it on Disney Plus because pretty much all of those, we talked about this last week, but pretty much all of those old movies, if they have a monkey in it, they're not on Disney Plus. I think it's just to protect Dan.
ironically enough, it's not my next one, but I do have one here sung by a monkey.
What?
I'll talk about that shortly.
Oh my goodness.
And no, his name is not Mickey Dolenz or Peter Tork or Davy Jones.
But yeah, that's another song. I mean, it's kind of like the theme song for that particular movie, which is a follow-up to The Misadventures of Merlin Jones. But yeah, I mean, it's just a lot of fun, and it's another one that I love to listen to. It's in my running mix, so I listen to it a lot. Cool.
Great. Awesome.
So Dan, you're up once again. Do you have anything else for us?
Yeah. So this was going to be my last one on my playlist that I have officially submitted. By the way, Disney has not gotten back to me as a guest host DJ, so I don't know. Maybe it's not good enough. But I was thinking about, am I being too, well, let's just say it, old? Am I being too old with these picks? And are the people that are listening to the radio that are my kids' ages, are they going to know any of this music? So I said it has to be a well-rounded list. And when I think back in 50 years from now, when I think back on my life, I think this song is going to be right up there in like one of my fondest memories. Even though right now I may like hate it on the surface because it's being played everywhere, but my kids absolutely love it, and it really is a good song. I'm talking about We Don't Talk About Bruno. I have watched that movie, Encanto. I've watched it at least 100 times over the last couple months. But I'm a huge Lin-Manuel Miranda fan. I'm a huge Hamilton fan. I think he does a great job. I love the music of Moana as well, which Lin-Manuel did music for. This song in particular, though, it has like such an awesome mix of like salsa and Latin music and a little bit of hip hop and dance and a little bit of Broadway. And that's what makes it awesome. And the best part about the song is the last minute, when every single one of those verses come together and all the characters sing it in the same beat, in the same rhythm. And it's something where the first time I heard it, I said to myself, wow, this is a really well-written song, the way they were able to do this, even though I may have not liked it off the bat. It's grown on me. I think it's going to be a Disney classic, if it's not already. And that last part, I mean, that last verse, I don't care who you are. If you know the song, you're picking one of the characters and you're singing that part while they're all harmonizing. That's just how it works.
You know, I seriously considered putting Surface Pressure from Encanto on my list.
Yep.
Because again, I mean, Lin-Manuel Miranda. Did I get that right?
Yeah, you got it right.
he does a great job with all of his songs, and I agree. I mean, I agree that Moana was also a lot of fantastic music. But yeah, Surface Pressure for me from the movie Encanto is the one that finally grew on me to the point that I just absolutely love it.
Yeah, and Surface Pressure was supposed to be the single. You know, if you listen to, you know, the documentaries of Encanto, that's what they said. They thought Surface Pressure was going to be the breakout hit. And it is a hit. I think a lot of people love that song. But it's nowhere near what we don't talk about Bruno turned out to be.
Yeah, I know, like almost immediately after that film came out, because I remember saying even on this show, when we were talking about Encanto, that I'm like, you know, I didn't really get into some of the music right away. But I had already noticed that just about everyone was talking about We Don't Talk About Bruno. It was a huge hit instantaneously. So that is definitely a good pick.
Yep, definitely.
Beatrice.
So my next one, I tried to find something on the newer version, but I went inside the theme park with it, with Mickey and Minnie's Runaway Railway on the Runamuck Park train. When we go on the train and we're ready for a relaxing ride around the park with Goofy as our conductor. And then all of a sudden, at the end of the ride, we get to Nothing Can Stop Us Now. And I walk out of that ride singing that song the entire day.
Nothing can stop us now. I'll tell you how. We're gonna make it happen. Let's take a ride and spend the day in the countryside.
Good times are here to stay. We'll get away and have the perfect picnic. We'll sing.
Nothing can stop us now. I don't know how it could be any better. We'll travel
Like that little earworm, nothing can stop us now. Like, I mean, you just can't get it out of your head. So for that reason alone, Mickey and Minnie are by your side. Nothing can stop us. The fireworks is happening. The picnic is going on. You walk out singing. And then you love that little bird too. It's adorable. So if you have ever seen that ride, if not, you will definitely know that cute little birdie as soon as you go through there. You'll know exactly what I'm talking about. They even sell it in merchandise. So, you know, Disney, when something is cute like that, you got a merchandise all over it. But it's adorable and I so love it. So that is definitely one that I can't stop singing. So I had to bring it up today. It's my favorite.
Yeah, It's a great song, and Disney does such a great job of the music that they put into their theme parks as well. Mm-hmm. We've talked a lot about a lot of the different movies and such, but yeah, the theme park attractions as well always has such great music. I'm actually going to go back to a movie though for my next pick. And it's a movie I have talked about on here before, and it's the Tigger movie. It's one that I love the movie because Tigger is one of my favorite characters, but it just almost destroys me to watch this film when I see happy-go-lucky Tigger feeling so sad and depressed because it's so out of his character. But putting that aside, the whoop-de-dooper bounce. The whoop-de-dooper, loop-de-looper, alley-ooper bounce that he sings with Little Roo is one of the catchiest, bounciest, of most fun songs, not just in that movie, but ever. And so that is one of my next picks.
You can't bounce the bounce if you can't even pronounce the bounce. Repeat after Tigger. Loop-de-dooper, loop-de-looper, alley-ooper bounce. The whoop-de-dooper, loop-de-looper, alley-ooper bounce. It's got the zip that makes you flip, and that's what really counts. In the whoop-de-dooper, loop-de-looper, alley-ooper bounce. Now, half this bounce is 90% mental. If you calculate the specific Tigger trajectory, your sprite acceleration dies if it's by the square root of your rebounce, your vertical situation indicator, and your striposonic spring inertia should ricochet your hydrolific fuselage into an accelerometric deorbit. Any questions?
When do I get to learn the whooping whooper whooper? I mean the whooper whooper whooper.
The whoop-de-dooper, loop-de-looper, alley-ooper bounce. The whoop-de-dooper, loop-de-looper, alley-ooper bounce. The more you try, the more you fly, and that's what really counts. And the whoop-de-dooper, loop-de-looper, alley-ooper bounce.
Oh, I love it. So go into that again. Can you repeat the whole loop-de-loop?
The whoop-de-dooper, loop-de-looper, alley-ooper bounce.
I love it.
This is, again, one that I listen to a lot. So it's like, yeah, that's almost burned in my brain now.
Oh, I just had to make you say it again. It's just too cute.
But like I say, Tigger is like one of my favorite characters because he's so bouncy and exuberant and happy and upbeat, like all the time. And I was happy to see him get his own movie, and then to see him be so devastated at points throughout the film it just rips me up inside to watch. So I actually have a hard time watching his film.
Love it. I understand. He is terrific.
So Dan, we have time for another round, I think.
Sure. All right. If we're only going to do one more round, I think I have to go with this one, the last one I did was 2021. Let's go 81 years earlier. And I think that this song is like the Disney signature song. If I had to think of a signature song for the Walt Disney Company, I'm going with When You Wish Upon a Star.
Oh.
Thank you.
back to the original iconic.
Iconic song. We can't have an episode without about music, Disney music, without bringing this song up. The song was written and recorded in 1939, and the movie was released in 1940. The song was sung by Cliff Edwards, who played Jiminy Cricket. And the way that he sings that song, we could all hear it in our heads right now, probably. That slow way that he sings it, just so, you know, you can't even pretend to copy it, you know, in my opinion. Like, you don't really hear people try to do an impression of that song, really. People do have done their own interpretations, but to me, it's the perfect Disney song. It's the song that I always think of, like at the end of the night. I always hear it on Main Street. They usually play it at nighttime. And it's just, I don't know, in my opinion, like the ultimate Disney song. Also, speaking of Academy Awards, I know I've mentioned that a few times. This one actually won an Academy Award in 1940.
That is an absolutely epic pick because, yeah, again, it is so classic and so iconic and goes back even before there were parks.
Yep. And actually, little known fact, I don't know if you guys know this, you guys are both fellow Scandinavian heritage, right? So absolutely. Do you guys know, I know this from my cousins who I'm very close with in Norway, that this song has become a Christmas Eve tradition. And it's basically a Christmas song in Scandinavia. And there's I should have had my notes here on this one, but there's some sort of Mickey like special that was out there. I'll put it in the show notes, or I'll have Jay put it in the show notes, that's played every Christmas Eve in Norway, Sweden, Denmark, I think even Japan. And this song is sung by Jiminy Cricket, and it's a major Christmas song in Scandinavia.
Wow. Oh, that is awesome.
That is. Very
and cool. I did not know that.
I did not know that either.
We learned something. Thank you for sharing that with us. So we'll definitely have to see about getting a link to that in the show notes. So
I'm gonna look it up right now.
Further information with our passengers on that.
Here it is. I just looked it up. It's called From All of Us to All of You. It's an animated television Christmas special produced by the Walt Disney Productions. In 1958, as part of Walt Disney's Presents, hosted by Jiminy Cricket.
That sounds like something that came from the old anthology series.
Yep. So it's called From All of Us to All of You. That's look that up.
Okay.
Love it.
I love it. Absolutely. Beatrice, one last one.
So my last one, I cannot miss having this in the show. It's from my very first ever Disney vacation in 2000, and I will never ever forget the lasting impact of that on how Disney changed my life forever. I waited till I was an adult to get to Disney World, and that trip changed my life forever. And I'm going with We Go On from Epcot. The entire Millennium celebration.
There comes a time to understand, to reach out and touch tomorrow. Take the future in our hand. We can see a new horizon built on all that we have done. Dreams begin another thousand circles around the sun.
Just the words of the song, the meaning of what it meant at that time, and and how it lasted a good 20 years. But with the stillness of the night, there comes a time to understand, to reach out and touch tomorrow, take the future hand in hand. It was just a beautiful symbol of the whole world coming together and the new century in front of us. It was something that was written by Don Dorsey, the production director and creator. It was written in 2019 for the Millennium Celebration, and it is definitely one that we can't miss. I also loved Celebrate the Future Hand in Hand at that time, but We Go On is absolutely by far the whole.
I'm just completely amused by the fact that that was the one I was going to say next.
Oh no!
That's literally what I had queued up.
We totally can't miss it. Yeah, absolutely.
I thought about emailing you guys.
It's so fantastic because it came like right. Basically, it wasn't really part of Illuminations. It was like it was played like immediately after the fireworks show ended, mm-hmm. as you were leaving the park, as you were getting ready to walk out. You know, so it's almost like the after show music, but it is so amazing. And I had the CD of that music from that time, and I've listened to that over and over again. And you're right, you know, Celebrate the Future Hand in Hand is another one that goes right along with it. So that is an absolutely fantastic pick, and you stole it from me.
When it gets to that point, we go on through the joy and through the tears. I always, that's where I kind of lose it right there. Cause it's like, you mm-hmm. think about all the moments that you've had in your life and you know, the future is among us and that kind of, it's just the perfect essence of a Disney song. So sorry, Ken.
That's all right. So here's the thing. Since you took mine, I'm going to go in a completely different direction. Okay. And yeah, the listeners of course can't see the shirt that I'm wearing, but I am once again wearing one of my many Hawaiian shirts, but this one is from Weird Al Yankovic from one of his concerts. And I mention that because the song I'm going to tell everyone about is also by Weird Al Yankovic. And it's the theme song to Milo Murphy's Law called It's My World and We're All Living in It. So I don't know if either of you two have watched Milo Murphy's World, but... It's kind of a follow-up to Phineas and Ferb. It's by the same people, but Weird Al Yankovic does the voice of Milo Murphy, and it's a fun show where his character is always very upbeat and very never getting down. He's always just trying to figure out how to get through one thing to the next, because he lives under Murphy's Law, which means that anything that can go wrong does go wrong. And so he is always dealing with all sorts of craziness that results from all of that. And he never lets it get him down the whole time. He's always optimistic. And it's a lot. It's a fun show. I think you both would enjoy it very much. If you haven't watched it, I highly recommend it. And of course, it's Weird Al Yankovic. So, you know, some of the music is great between him and the fact that we've got the people who did all that wonderful music for Phineas and Ferb. It's a great show.
Oh, it sounds great. I'll have to look that up.
I am curious to know what our passengers, our listeners feel about our list. I really want to hear what everyone has to say. Do you agree with them? Do you not agree with them? Did we miss something completely? It's probably someone screaming at their phone right now saying, what? You didn't put blah, blah, blah on. So we're sorry.
Yeah, I want to hear every single one of those songs that you think we should have talked about but didn't. I want you to tell us every single one of them, because they're all great. I will probably agree with you on all of them, that they are all great. So by all means, come at us. Tell us your picks as well, because we want to hear them.
And there's probably ones that we don't know. I mean, I know Justin just named that last one. I have no idea what you're talking about, but it's on my list now that I will go listen to.
Yeah, go watch Milo Murphy. It's on Disney Plus. It's two seasons. It's a lot of fun. It's an animated show, like I say, by the people of Phineas and Ferb. So... do we have any last thoughts or honorable mentions before we head out? We'll start with you, Dan, quick, before we head out.
honorable mentions. Oh my goodness, there's so many. Seriously, let's do a part two. Next time the three of us together, I think we should do a part two.
I'm totally up for that.
Cool.
I agree. My music, or my notes were all over the place too, because I was so torn between, you know, the decades of great music in the movies and then the rides and the attractions and special events and things like that. Several parade music that I really wanted to talk about that I have here. And I was flipping back and forth on my list because I didn't know where I was going to go next, much less, you know, like I was one moment I was going to do this one and one moment I was going to do something else. So
there's absolutely. There's so many that we didn't even mention a single song by the Sherman Brothers. Exactly. That's how many songs.
That is crazy that we didn't do that. I know. I mean, heck, how do we not have something from Mary Poppins on our list, right? Like, I feel like dirty not doing that, you know?
Exactly. There's so many great ones over the years. And then I was going to go into one that I'll just have to do this one honorable mention, because it's one that many people don't know about. But if you do come to Disney, be on the lookout. If you do have a rainy day storm, be on the lookout for the rainy day parade. That song from the Rainy Day Parade, I've been singing it all weekend because we've had a rainy week here. And it's like, jingle, jingle, splish, splash, tell me how long will this rain last? So like, I'm singing, every time there's a rainstorm that comes through, I'm like, tell me how long will this rain last?
I have an idea. Instead of the Dan game for our meetup, I'll bring a karaoke machine that we just sing
Disney songs.
Oh, well, in that case, I'll bring some of my karaoke discs because I have some.
Exactly.
Fair warning to everyone.
They're so great. There's so much to choose from.
Well, awesome. And with that, passengers, we have come up to our spaceport and we are ready to dock. So thank you all for joining us on this wonderful adventure. As Dan says, we're gonna have to come back and do a part two, possibly a part three, four, five, six, up through I don't know how many, because there's so many great songs throughout all of the decades of Disney music. But with that, Ken, take it away.
Life's like a movie, write your own ending. Keep believing, keep pretending, we've done just what we said.
If you would like to keep the adventure going after the show, be sure to like our Facebook friends page, Grand Circle Tours Magical Ticket Holders. While you're on Facebook, like our group page, Grand Circle Tours. Be sure to follow us on Twitter, Grand Circle Tours Podcast, as well as on Instagram, GCT Podcast, and our YouTube channel, Grand Circle Tour. If you would like to email us, drop us a line at gctpodcast@gmail.com. T-shirts and other fun merchandise can be found at tpublic.com. Simply search Grand Circle Tour Podcast. If you enjoyed your adventure, leave us a review on Apple Podcast. Only one rule, make it good. All logos, sounds, songs, and music that are made by and for Disney and its affiliates are the full ownership of the Disney Corporation and are not, nor are they intended to be, the ownership of the Grand Circle Tour Podcast. Thank you for riding with us, and welcome home.
Please exit to your left by stepping away from the cars with your left foot first. Step out and stand on the moving platform, please.
Please exit by stepping away from the cars with your left foot first. Step out and stand on the moving platform, please.